Hello and welcome to NewsClip. Nothing drives us more than standing in solidarity with people's movements. Our teams are on the ground covering these movements extensively and hoping to bring out a change. In this segment, we bring you a roundup of various such movements that have taken place across the country over the past few weeks. Over a dozen people were killed and many others, including women and children, were injured in a brutal police attack and firing on the people protesting against Sterlite copper plant in Tamil Nadu. Now, this copper plant has long been opposed because it causes pollution to the environment and a various range of health problems to the residents. Following the incidents, protests erupted across the country opposing this firing.
That's why if we are demanding for our food, for clean air, for clean water, for clean land to be disease-free, why is that something that will get us shot?
On 23rd May, under the banner of Jan Ekta Jan Adhikar Andolan, thousands of people from different mass and class organizations marched in different cities across India. They had a 27-point charter of demands which questioned the anti-people policies of Modi government, which have led to the deterioration of the lives of the common people.
The government should change the policies. If the government is not willing to, then the people will come to change the government.
Bank employees across India began a two-day strike on 30th May, protesting the measly 2% hike in wages, which has been stagnant for almost 6 years. All employees of the public sector banks and majority of the private sector banks are participating in this nationwide strike, which has been called by the United Forum of Bank Unions.
इसी तरह से अगर नीरव मोदी, मेहुल चौकसी, मल्ला जैसे लोग हजारों करोड़ लेके जाते रहेंगे और जो कर्मचारी अधिकारी बैंकों में सिंसियरली काम करते रहे इतने वर्षों तक खामियाजा उनको भुगतना पड़ेगा तो ये तो कोई जस्टिफिकेशन नहीं हुआ ना उसके अंदर.
Teachers and students faced the scorching heat and participated in massive numbers in the Delhi University Teachers Association Satyagraha and mass hunger strike on 30th May at Delhi's Parliament Street. The focus of the strike was UGC's standing notification, which has asked all colleges and universities to redraw their reservation rosters on the basis of departments as units.
This hunger strike, the focus issue for this hunger strike, of course there are many issues like autonomy, there are issues about pay revision, service conditions, but the focus issue is about what the government is doing with regard to its own reservation policy.
Nearly 3 lakh Grameen Dak Sevak employees of postal department across India are on an indefinite strike since May 22nd. Now what they are demanding is an immediate implementation of the Kamlesh Chandra Committee report recommendation. This historic strike challenges the apathetic attitude of the NDA government in addressing the issues faced by these workers. That's all for this week. To follow detailed reports on these protests and movements, please visit our website and Facebook page. Thank you.